one of the most enjoyable units for me and the students, where the students do really achieve a lot, is in databases. And this is for several reasons. The unit is quite practical, and we have lessons that we learn the concepts, but we also work in groups to practice those concepts and also devise a project where we transfer the skills that we've learned to the project that we decide what the focus is. So the format is we choose a database that we want to create. We start off learning the design concepts, really based around an entity relationship diagram. Now, students spend quite a long time tinkering with this diagram, but finish up with something that's quite simple, but correct. Now, to do databases, we use SQL, and we can use any database, but in a quick course, if you like, we learn quickly, we can use something like SQLite. We can connect to that database using something like ODBC. And now we come to the part where we use Python. Now, if we use the internet, for example, to buy things, we see a user interface. Now, the details about the items and transactions are all stored in a database. But there needs to be something in between the interface and the database, and that's where Python comes in. So we find that this task of creating this middle tier in Python that takes the user's requests and then interacts with the databases, like getting details and updating the database, this exercise, this project, really matures students' Python skills and is enjoyable. So in the next level of Python is applying their skills to a project, and we can do that in databases. So we can look at the design side, where we're really talking about like an ER diagram. There are other areas such as normalization. We understand the use of primary keys and relationships, so that's a relational database concept. We can do top-down design, bottom-up design. We're looking at the whole area of designing a database. Now, the database, we can write that in SQL, data definition language, where we create table, and we can also manipulate the database with SQL select queries and other types of queries for insert, update, and delete. So now we've got our database, we've done the design, we create it in SQL. Now we actually want to use it. So we can use a Python program. Let's say, for example, we create a menu system, and we're going to use that as a simple interface. We can always start simple and develop our program. We can add on the bits that we want to do, but let's start off simple. We want to get something that works, that achieves the main goals, and then we can develop it and improve it and add on the things that we want afterwards. So we have our database, we can create our interface. So now we have to think, what do we want? What's the user actually going to want? So if we have, for example, an item, let's say a computer, and we have a person who wants to buy the computer, we need to create the details of the computer to give to the customer. We want to create some type of account for the customer, so their name, maybe some details about the customer, and also the transaction. So we can see here that this middle tier, this Python program that can act also as the interface in this case, but can interact, can connect to the database, and we can embed the SQL statements inside the Python. So the Python program is our project. Databases is the subject, the unit, and we learn a lot about databases. But to implement it, we really need to use our Python skills. So if you would like to learn a little bit about databases and improve your Python, why not choose a project choose the type of database that you want to create, and then follow along with the next few videos, create the database and create the Python that you'll need to manipulate the data inside the database. If you want to be notified when these videos are released, then click that subscribe button and that notification bell, and why not click the like button?